recording and implantation of rill. First, rill with appropriate power is removed from the pack. Next, the aluminium foil is peeled from the pack's base, exposing the rill inside the sterile solution. Next, viscoelastics are injected along the cannula and base of the butterfly cartridge. Rill with vault facing up is placed over the butterfly cartridge and gently tapped to lock it inside the base of cartridge, followed by closure of wings and fixing it to the injector, eventually pushing the plunger to see the smooth forward movement of rill. A 2.8 self-sealing clear corneal temporal incision is constructed. A sight port is made along superotemporal quadrant, followed by injection of preservative-free intracameral lignocaine and HPMC viscoelastics into the intracameral space to create a space between corneal endothelium and the surface of crystalline lens. Another sight port was made at the inferotemporal quadrant. Next, rill is injected into the anterior chamber with a slow controlled push technique with vault facing up and seeing the peripheral hole of the leading haptic along the right hand side. Then the leading haptic is slowly guided behind the iris with the help of guider, followed by guiding of the trailing haptic behind the iris. Ensuring the centration of the rill over the crystalline lens, followed by removal of viscoelastics with the help of irrigation aspiration probe or with the help of Simcoe cannula, ensuring complete removal of the viscoelastics. A gentle tap is done over the surface of rill to remove the viscoelastics from the interface between the rill and the surface of crystalline lens. Complete removal of viscoelastics is mandatory to prevent any postoperative intraocular pressure spikes. Finally, the anterior chamber is formed with balanced salt solution and injection of intracameral preservative-free moxifloxacin eye drops.